Good day friends, here we are with our CAE slide part 3. In this slide we will cover all about different static analysis calculations like front impact, rear impact, rollover, bump and torsional. So please stay with us till the end as we gonna share all the calculations and a slide layout at the end. So the key points which we should consider while working on this slide, that is calculation. You should have a handwritten calculation of each of these five analysis, and there should be ANSYS report of ANSYS or Hypermesh, whichever software you are using. You should also know basics about CAE, so that if they ask you about questions about CAE, you will be able to tackle it. And process, you should remember the process of how you started designing in SolidWorks, then you import it in ANSYS, then which point you constrained during which analysis, then how much load you have put at what point in which analysis. So process also you should remember. So now we will look after each and every calculation. First we will start with front impact. So front impact, we have considered formula of impulse momentum equation, F equal to M into A upon time. So here we have considered 210 as a total mass of vehicle with driver. Okay, so 210 which we have considered here, it's total mass of vehicle with driver in kgs, and 11.12 we have considered because acceleration as per endurance condition we have considered. Okay, so if you look at the previous year's endurance clip, you will understand that there are lots of hurdles, and there are around hundreds of vehicle in that track. So I don't think so there will be any point where a vehicle will run at 60 km per hour, because there are constant hurdles, and vehicle general speed during endurance is around 40 to 45 km per hour. So as per that we have considered the acceleration, and it is around 11.12. so when you will convert 40 km per hour into meter per second, we will get 11.12 answer. And impact time we have considered 0.15 as per there are general standards which we will mention in the description. You can go through it. So there are general standards of considering the impact time. So for front impact it is 0.15 seconds, and front impact in terms of G, if you want to describe, so 210 into 9.81 into 8 equal to 16,480 newtons. So it is approx, and what we have got is 15,568 newton. So It is approx. It is about 7.6 g. We can take approx 8 g for front impact with the help of this calculation. So for front impact, front impact and for rear impact, all suspension, both front and rear points, we will fix. And there is a note that when we will do rear impact, the only change we have to do is in the time, that is 0.15 for front, and for rear impact it will be 0.3 seconds. Okay, now about side impact. So side impact, we will use the same formula. We will just change the time of impact, that is 0.3 seconds, and same mass we will consider M as vehicle with driver weight, total weight, and again we will consider acceleration as per endurance condition. And for side impact, it is coming about 3.8 g with this load, and as per load varies, it will be around 4 g. So in side impact we will constrain points. If we are doing left side impact, then right side suspension points are fixed, and if we are doing right side impact, then left side suspension points are fixed. So after this we will look after rollover. So rollover, in rollover condition we have considered impact time of 0.15 seconds. So we have here we have done kinetic energy equal to potential energy. So with this formula, we have equate both the terms, and as mass was common, so we have cut the mass, and after that we have value of g and h. So we calculated the velocity in meter per second first, and then we converted it into kilometer per hour. It is kilometer per hour. Okay, so after this work done, so work done equal to change in kinematics. So we have calculated the work done with considering mass and velocity. So we have got 3005.36 newton of work done, and we have got the displacement with considering the impact time. It is 0.5 impact time of 0.15 into the velocity meter per second. So you will get the displacement. So after that, rollover force, we will put force on what we can say, RHO. So we will put the force of 4321.15 newton, that is approx 2 g. So as here we have considered M is equal to mass of the vehicle, g is the gravitational acceleration, h is wheelbase, it is 58 inch in our case. So as per your condition you consider it and then convert it into mm, and then consider convert it into meter, and the meter value we have to consider in the calculation. Okay, So V is the velocity meter per second, W is work done by vehicle, S is displacement in meter, and F equal to roll impact force in Newton. Constraint points for front rollover or rear rollover. Suspension points of both front and rear are fixed. For front rollover and for rear roll, both cases, both the suspension points will be fixed. So after this torsional analysis, for torsional analysis, we will consider K equal to torque upon angle of twist. So for torque, we will consider force into track width, half of the track width. So this is how our weight distribution is concerned of our vehicle. For front it is 45%, and for rear it is 55%. So when you are doing torsional analysis of front, then you will consider 45% of your weight, and so into 3 into g, and the L is equal to half of the track width. So we will calculate torque this way, and for angle of twist you will consider tan inverse z1 plus z2 upon 2l. So the z of 0.053, how this point came, we will explain it in by doing analysis in ANSYS. So with that we have get angle of twist is 4.4 degree, and with this we have calculated the torsional stiffness Newton meter per degree, 431.61, and here theta is angle of twist, T is torque, F is equal to front weight, and if it is real torsional analysis, it will be consider rear weight, we will consider, and deformation z1 z2 we will calculate during analysis. We will show you in our next video while we are doing in ANSYS how we will find out z1 z2 value, and L is equal to half of the track width. Here we have considered L, we have considered 0.68, and here also we have considered 0.68 in meters. So constraint points for front torsional, it will be rear suspension points will be fixed, and for rear torsional analysis, front suspension points will be fixed. So after this bump analysis, so while doing bump analysis, same we have to consider while front bump analysis, 45% of the weight into acceleration upon point of impact, time of impact, 0.3 seconds. So we will get the front bump force of 3502.8 Newton in our case. So don't take directly these values, put your vehicle values, replace this while doing your calculation. And same mass, total weight of the vehicle with driver, acceleration as per endurance concerned. So bump, it will be 1.8 g. It will be around 1.5 to 2g generally, and in our case it is 1.8g. So constraint points for for front bump impact, rear suspension points are fixed, and for rear bump impact, front suspension points are fixed. Okay, so what all should be there in this slide, CE slide? So there should be a table of values of deformation during various analysis, your factor of safety and maximum stress induced, and there should be analysis photos of bump, torsional, front impact, rear impact, side impact, and also rollover. And here point you have to mention number of nodes, elements, element size, all of these points where you will find, we will see in the next video. And also we will see which kind of ANSYS image should be put, and this, there is a layout which we would like to share with you. So all the sixth analysis, front rear, front rollover, side impact, front bump, torsional analysis, okay, so force you applied, total deformation, maximum stress, factor of safety, and roll case stiffness, all these values, you will, total force applied, we will get with the calculation we have shown, and rest of this we will find it in ANSYS after the analysis. So if you didn't get this all points, we will show it in next video how to find out this all points and the images, six images, material properties. Material properties is compulsory as they cross check during virtual, as our experience, they have cross checked during our virtual presentation. So they will take a maximum stress upon the material ultimate stress. So they will see the factor of safety, whatever you have mentioned are accurate, or you have put some random values. So don't put random values, put the genuine values. If you have any doubt, if you didn't able to find the genuine values of factor of safety and your stress and deformation, if it is too much, then you can comment us and you can mail us. We will try to solve it for you, and this all things we will find out in ANSYS module, which will be on in next video. And do mention design is safe at the last as a conclusion. And after this, thanks for coming to us and referring our articles and calculation. If you have any doubts related to automobile, please do comment, because we respond to each and every comment of yours. And if you will comment, then we will understand your problem, and then we will able to solve it. So this is LTV Calculation signing off. Thank you, and do subscribe, because as soon as we will complete this Baha virtual presentation lecture series, we will again switch to the ANSYS and HyperMesh module series. So you will get notified. To subscribe. Thank you.